Today I shall be talking to you about the Renaissance in Europe. The Renaissance in Europe was an active period of European cultural, artistic, political and economic rebirth following the Middle Ages, generally described as taking place from the 14th century to the 17th century. The Renaissance promoted the rediscovery of classical philosophy, literature and art. Some of the greatest thinkers, authors, statesmen, scientists and artists in human history thrived during this era. While global exploration opened up new lands and cultures to European trade and commerce, the Renaissance, regarded as the bridge between the Middle Ages and modern-day civilization. The word Renaissance itself comes from the French phrase Renaissance des lettres, used by the 19th century historian Jules Michelet. In Old French, Renaissance means rebirth. Several causes have been identified by historians which led to the rise of Renaissance in Europe, including increased interaction between different cultures, the rediscovery of ancient Greek and Roman texts, the emergence of humanism, different artistic and technological innovations, and the impacts of conflict and death. Now, what were the Middle Ages? Middle Ages is identified as a period that took place between the fall of ancient Rome in 476 AD and the beginning of the 14th century. Europeans made few advances in science and art during this period. Also known as the Dark Ages, the era is often branded as a time of war, ignorance, famine and pandemics such as the Black Death. Though some historians believe that such depictions of the Middle Ages were greatly exaggerated, yet many agreed that there was relatively little regard for ancient Greek and Roman philosophies and learning at this time. Humanism. During the 14th century, a cultural movement called Humanism began to gain momentum in Italy. It was a major intellectual movement of the Renaissance. Amongst its many principles, Humanism promoted the idea that man was the center of his own universe, and people should embrace human achievements in education, classical arts, literature, and science. When historians speak of Renaissance humanism, they are referring to the most predominant characteristic movement of the time period that valued ancient Greek and Roman literature styles, ideologies, and their insights into human nature. In 1450 AD, the invention of the Gutenberg printing press allowed for improved communication throughout Europe and for ideas to spread more quickly. As a result of this advance in communication, little known texts from early humanist authors such as those by Francesco Petrarch and Giovanni Boccaccio, which promoted the renewal of traditional Greek and Roman culture and values, were printed and distributed to the masses. Additionally, many scholars believe advances in international finance and trade impacted culture in Europe and set the stage for the Renaissance. The Renaissance started in Florence, Italy, a place with a rich culture heritage. Members of the powerful Medici family, which ruled Florence for more than 60 years, were famous supporters of the movement. Many Italian writers, artists, politicians and others declared that they were participating in an intellectual and artistic revolution different from the experiences of the Dark Ages. Renaissance humanism spread to the other Italian city-states such as Venice, Milan, Bologna, Ferrara and Rome. Later the movement picked speed and in the 15th century, Renaissance ideas spread from Italy to France and then throughout Western and Northern Europe. Some of the most famous Renaissance geniuses include the likes of Leonardo da Vinci, the Italian painter, architect and inventor, and the Renaissance man responsible for painting the Mona Lisa and the Last Supper. Then Erasmus, the scholar from Holland who identified the humanist movement in Northern Europe. He was also the translator of the New Testament into Greek. Descartes, the French philosopher and mathematician, Galileo, the Italian astronomer, physicist and engineer whose pioneering work with telescopes enabled him to describe the moons of Jupiter and the rings of the Saturn. Copernicus, the mathematician and astronomer. Thomas Hobbes, the English philosopher and author of Leviathan. Geoffrey Chaucer, English poet and the author of Canterbury Tales. Dante, Italian philosopher, poet, writer and political thinker who authored the Divine Comedy. Niccolò Machiavelli, Italian diplomat and philosopher famous for writing The Prince and the Discourses on Livy. John Milton, the English poet and historian who wrote the epic Paradise Lost. William Shakespeare, England's national poet and the most famous playwright of all the times. Donatello, the Italian sculptor who celebrated lifelike sculptures like David, commissioned by the Medici family. Raphael, the Italian painter, and Michelangelo, the Italian sculptor, painter, and architect who carved David and painted the Sistine Chapel in Rome. Development of art, architecture, and science were closely linked during the Renaissance. In fact, it was a unique time when these fields of study fused together seamlessly. Artists like Leonardo da Vinci incorporated scientific principles such as anatomy into their work, so they could recreate the human body with extraordinary precision. Architects such as Filippino Brunelleschi studied mathematics to accurately engineer and design huge buildings with expansive domes. Scientific discoveries led to major leaps in thinking. Galileo and Descartes presented a new view of astrology and mathematics, while Copernicus proposed that the sun, not the earth, was the center of the solar system. Renaissance art was characterized by realism and naturalism. Artists strive to depict people and objects in a true-to-life way. They use techniques such as perspective, shadows, and light to add depth to their work. Emotion was another quality that artists tried to infuse into their pieces. Some of the most famous artists were produced during the Renaissance period. Many Europeans also undertook voyages to learn more about the world around them. In a period known as the Age of Discovery, several important explorations were made. They discovered new shipping routes to the Americas, India, and the Far East. Ferdinand Magellan, Christopher Columbus, Amerigo Vespucci, Marco Polo, Vasco de Balboa, and Hernando de Soto and other explorers went on many famous sea voyages. Humanism encouraged Europeans to question the role of the Roman Catholic Church during the Renaissance. The movement emphasized on the use of logic and reasoning. As more and more people learned how to read, write, and interpret ideas, they began to question various practices used by the church and the religious leaders. The printing press also played a vital role and allowed for texts, including the Bible, to be easily reproduced and widely read by the people themselves. For the first time, rationalism became the mantra of Europe. In the 16th century, Martin Luther, a German monk, led the Protestant Reformation, a revolutionary movement that caused a split in the Catholic Church. Luther questioned many of the practices of the Church and whether they aligned with the teachings of the Bible. As a result, a new form of Christianity, known as Protestantism, was created. Scholars believe the demise of Renaissance was a result of several compounding factors. By the end of the 15th century, numerous wars, change of trade routes, led to the decline of the movement. In 1545, the Council of Trent established the Roman Inquisition, which made humanism and any views that challenged the Catholic Church an act of heresy punishable by death. By the early 17th century, the Renaissance movement had died out, giving way to the Age of Enlightenment.